I'd like to introduce the Philippine Crop Insurance Corporation to you. Philippine Crop Insurance Corporation is the agency that I represent. And Philippine Crop Insurance Corporation is one of the most in-demand agencies today. As you all know, we are in the spell, under the spell of climate change phenomenon. Okay? So for my topic outline, I have there on the screen, I'll give to you a background of PCIC, and then I'll present to you the different agricultural insurance programs of PCIC, and then we have our PCIC special insurance programs, and we have our marketing channels. Okay, so before I give PCIC background to you, let me bring you to a reality or to a certain scenario. Today, it's inevitable that growth happens, whether we like it or not. So we have to grow. In fact, why we are here is because we would like to grow. So we may have existing businesses now, but still we would like to grow our respective businesses. Ang pinaka-basic growth which we have to reckon with is the growth on population. O, di ba? Kaya palay ang kampanya ng government natin ng decreasing our number of children para medyo ma-reduce natin yung population. Because along with growth in population, sunod ng sunod yung mga other growth requirements. And this bursting growth brings us to some concerns in the social environment, in economy, and you know. So as we grow in population, there is a demand for enough food. So kaya ngayon, kinukulang tayo ng food, kinukulang tayo ng space, pati sa mga housing, pati sa lupa, o di ba? Okay. So, and because growth is inevitable, we really have to address it. Okay. So, addressing growth, we do something. And one of this is your economic activity. Para sa ganoon po, magkaroon ng growth in our economy and business is necessary. But what are necessary inputs to businesses? Ang unang-unang, which is also another reality, is ang backbone ng economy natin are the farmers. And the farmers compose, and they are in the rural areas, they compose 70% of the population. But the irony of it, they compose the backbone of the economy, but the poorest reside in the rural areas, and in particular, among the fee farmers and the fisher folk. And about itong 70% na ito, 57% of them live in poverty. So again, in line with the desire to grow, is we would like to propel business, we would like to propel economy, but we cannot do away with the farmers along this line. Of course, kayo who are the business-minded, kayo ang basic na nagpropropel. Why? Because by establishing your businesses, you also give employment opportunity, di ba? Okay. So that in any economic undertaking or in any business undertaking, there is what we call, we need capital. Okay. Going back to the farmers. The farmers today, hindi yung sasabihin nila na magsasaka lang ako. No. Because today, we have upgraded the category of the farmer. The farmers today now are also entrepreneurs and they are businessmen. Why? Because in order for them to have higher productivity, they have to have capital. And having capital, they must be able to manage their capital. For the Philippine Crop Insurance Corporation and its background, I'd like to say that the Philippine Crop Insurance Corporation is the country's major crop insurance provider. Hindi lang major. It's the sole agricultural insurance provider. Bakit mag-isa ang PCIC nang magbibigay ng crop insurance? Okay? Kasi there is so much risk in agricultural undertaking. Kaya kinakailangan, kaya magkaroon ng reservations ang mga private players in agricultural insurance, medyo duda sila na mag-invest in farming because of the high risk. So you see it? Now, crop insurance has been defined as a financial management or a financial intervention. Because through insurance, considering the anticipated risk in our respective businesses, we would like to transfer some of the risk. Hindi yung kung ikaw ang gumagastos at pag nasalantayan o na damage, sarili mo na lang yung damage. Okay? Because insurance is there to transfer some of the risk. So mag-insure ka para pag nangyaring yung kapital mo ay nagkaroon ng hindi magandang pangyayari, then hindi yung kinakawawa mo lang yung sarili mo kasi you have something to lean on because you are insured. So PCIC is now 39 years in existence, pero 37 years in operation. So magaling ang Pilipino kasi ngayon pa lang, it was 10 years back when there was already a global call for global warming and lahat na yung mga warning na yan dahil sa climate change, matagal na ang Pilipinas dati nang naka-align, nakahanda. Kasi, look at it, 1978 pa, nandyan na yung crop insurance program. And then, we started by way of the proclamation of Presidential Decree 1647, and then we improved the services of crop insurance by way of amending it through Presidential Decree 1733 in 1980, and further strengthening it by another amendment in our charter through Republic Act 8175. So yun ang ano. And then, in 1998, kasi noon, crop insurance existed for the farmers alone. Sabi nung mga fisher folk, bakit spoiled ang ano lang, bakit ang mga farmers lang ang tinutulungan? Ano naman kami na fisher folk? At saka sumunod na rin dyan yung mga coconut farmers natin. And admittedly, and statistics shows that among the group of farmers, kasi farmers lahat yan, yung crop farmers, we have our coconut farmers and we have our fish farmers. The mas ano ang sitwasyon, poor, mas ano ang category in terms of poverty ng coconut farmers at saka ang PCA. Although, sabi nila, mayaman ang mga coconut farmers. Why? They have 75 billion na pera nila in the yung coconut levy fund. Okay. So, yun na. Nag-branch out na from farmers alone. Nag-branch out ng assistance ng government to fisher folk. So, that is the mission of crop insurance program. Because we said kanina, farming is a business. Again, when you are in business, I said, we have to have capital. But like I said, our farmers do not have the necessary capital. And so what do economists say? They say they need to be given credit. Okay. And who are the providers of credit? Rural banks, lending other lending institutions. Also, if they belong to a cooperative or associations which are able to provide them loans, then they avail of loans. But there is again one scenario in lending. Okay. Because of the high risk in agriculture, may pag-aalangan ang mga rural, ang mga may pera, sabihin na lang natin, ano, o yung mga tagapagbigay ng kapital na magpautang sa mga farmers dahil ito ay very vulnerable to the risk of climate change, and this could be the reason why afterwards hindi sila makapagbayad. O, di ba? And so, through, by way of crop insurance, sabi nung crop insurance diyan, it's going to stabilize income and it's going to ensure the flow of credit in the countryside. Kasi, here is a farmer, umutang siya. Unfortunately, or fortunately, yung inutang na kapital na yaan, nakitang maganda yung ano, may productivity doon sa na-start niya na business in the farm, but so suddenly, only 3 days or 5 days before harvest, namili na siya ng maraming sako para paglagyan niya ng palay niya, then here comes the typhoon. And so, it's beyond the control of men, di ba? So that, a farming or a farmer who is a businessman himself should consider crop insurance as a risk transfer mechanism. Kasi yung inutang niya yan na kapital, kung yun ay nasalanta o ano ba yan, na-damage, sabi natin, ay di wala na siyang makuhang harvest. O makapag-harvest man siya, affected na yung quality ng crop niya, mababa yung income niya, and that could be the reason why he could not pay his utang. And then, if he needs to start all over again his farming, definitely, hindi siya makapangutang ulit. Kasi naman sa utang is, utang, bayad. Para yun, sustained yung flow ng credit. So if one is insured, and one who is insured sustains damage, there is a chance na ibabalik ng insurance niya yung kapital niya at the time of loss and yung bayad diretso doon sa nagpautang upang sa ganoon, meron na naman ulit ipautang nung magpapautang. So, yun yung flow. So, that is one of the beauty of insurance. As a service oriented government institution attending to the insurance need of subsistence farmers and other agricultural stakeholders with utmost professionalism, integrity, and efficiency. Okay, ako magsasabi nito, but sabihin nyo may bias ako, but I'd like to say that PCIC has a core of values ng core of values dedicated to service with integrity, service with efficiency, service with professionalism. So that is what we are at PCIC, and that is one of our qualities to be able to attain our vision. And PCIC is a key factor in the realization of a vibrant and a progressive rural economy where Filipino farmers work with peace of mind under the protection of the crop agricultural insurance program. Okay, so sabi ko kanina, di ba, we in the Philippines today we have an average of 20 to 22 calamities a year. And then noon, yung calamity, yung typhoon natin noon, or ano, hindi masyadong ano. Noon, sabihin natin, parang magpasalamat pa tayo noon kung may typhoon. Kasi ito ay nagdudulot o nagdadala ng ulan. Okay. So, friendly pang typhoon noon. But na ngayon, I think we have destructive typhoons now. That is why we had our typhoons raised up to signal number 3 lang noon, di ba? But now, we have signal number 4 and we have signal number 5. So that explains the intensity or the changes we are encountering. So, pagka nandyan yung, in fact, sabi nga natin, one of the programs of government today is for disaster risk reduction and mitigation. Preparedness. Nandun yung preparedness. That is why, in all local government agencies today, down to the barangay levels, meron tayong mga drills, meron tayong mga training on how to be prepared to handle events of disasters. And in the field of agriculture farming, or in the field of agricultural undertaking and ventures, kasama sa paghahanda ay ang pag-a-avail ng farmer ng crop insurance. Upang sa ganoon, pagka mangyari ang hindi natin inaasahan, o mangyari ang ayaw natin mangyari, then meron tayong something to lean on. In fact, sabi sa ano ng insurance eh, kumbaga ang crop insurance, pag nahulog ka, parang caution 'yan. Na instead na direct na ang fall mo, mauntog ka sa semento, dadaan ka sa caution para hindi masyadong masakit. Okay? You know, ang efficiency, ang success ng isang corporation depends on who the people are managing the corporation, di ba? That is why I decided to present to you the board of directors or the policy making body of the Philippine Crop Insurance Corporation. So, we have 7 members of the board. One is the president of the Land Bank of the Philippines, the president of the Philippine Crop Insurance Corporation. We have a farmers representative for the Luzon group, farmers representative for the Visayas group, farmers representative in Mindanao, private insurance representative, and we have the director of the Agricultural Credit Policy Council. So, family ng DA yan, ang ACPC. Now, if you look on the screen, makita ninyo na majority ang voice ng farmers representative, di ba? So, yung mga farmers representative na ito, sila talaga yung spokesman o sila yung mouthpiece ng lahat ng farmers from all over the country upang pakipag-participate in decision making on how insurance should be implemented, kung ano-ano yung mga dapat na polisiya. So, hindi agrabyado o hindi nadedehado ang farmers because they have the majority of the voice. So, we now have the PC Agricultural Insurance Programs. So, ito-ito na yung mga programa o yung mga agribusiness undertaking natin na binibigyan ng crop insurance ng protection. So, yun ang regular insurance programs of PCIC. So, the first product line that we insured for crop for insurance in the agricultural products is rice. Bakit rice? Kasi rice naman kasi yung main staple food natin. Kaya yan ang unang pinagtuunan nung magsisimula pa lang ang programa ng crop insurance. Then afterwards, ang kasunod na staple crop natin is the corn, and so we had corn in 1982. And then because ang farmer after na magtanim, he has to keep himself busy, so meron siyang mga alagang hayop, di ba? And so, ano din, vulnerable din yung mga hayop to climate change events. That is why in 1988, we implemented our livestock insurance. And then, yung fishery natin doon sa last doon. We had our fishery insurance that was only in 1998 when it was included kasama doon sa fishery code natin. So, ni request na fisheries should also be covered in agricultural insurance. Ngayon, to make farming an enjoyable and a convenient undertaking, ang farmers, meron silang ginagamit na makina. Yung mga, we have now today, planters, we have now reaper, tractors, and I think, threshers. One of the major program now of the new secretary for DA is mechanization of farming. Bakit gusto nang i-mechanize yung farming? Alam mo, may survey kasi na pati yung mga farmers, yung mga anak nila, ayaw na nilang mag-farming. And that's going to be a serious problem. That is why DA now is also implementing program na how we can attract and we can make farming an attractive venture for our mga anak. Hindi yung puro mag-IT, pumunta sa abroad, mga ano, kasi malaking dagok yon sa economy ng Philippines, country natin. And then we have agricultural crops. Kita ninyo yan, yung mga sili, may mga sayote, may karabasa. So lahat yan nung production undertakings natin, from vegetable to the ornamental plants to the trees. Whether they are just non-fruit-bearing trees or fruit-bearing trees, lahat yan na i-insure natin. And then, yung mga farmers, we have there our credit life and term insurance. So that is the credit life insurance for the agriculture sector. Kasi aminin natin na anumang teknolohiya ang ating gagamitin in agriculture, whatever development on whatever modernization that takes place in agriculture, the most important component in the agriculture undertaking is the farmer himself. So hindi ba masyadong embarrassing o parang walang pagpapahalaga sa buhay ng farmer kung yung palayan niya, yung maisan niya, yung mga hayop na alaga niya ay naka-insure, pero yung sarili niyang buhay is not insured. So, in recognition of the life and the lives of our farmers, back in 2005, we implemented the credit and life term insurance program for our farmers. So, iyan ang rice crop insurance natin, and on the other side is the corn crop insurance. So, ito yung protection na binibigay natin para doon sa mga farmers who are in rice and corn production. Sabi ko kanina, di ba, hindi farmers lang ang tawag natin sa kanila, but they are themselves businessmen or entrepreneurs. Kasi malaking kapital. Actually, today, ang kapital para sa isang ektaryang rice farm, and that is the minimum, is 25,000. Okay. And that minimum can go up to a maximum of 45,000 kung siya ay nag-farm ng hybrid, and kung siya pati ang farming undertaking niya is seed production, it can go up to 65,000. So it's such a big capital, di ba? Pag yun ang nawala sa farmer. So for our rice crop insurance, we protect the risk of the farmer in his farming activity against natural calamities. Ano yung mga natural calamities na yan? We have the most common, we have typhoon, we have flood, we have drought, and very recently, we included tornado among the risks. Okay. And the same thing is true in corn. And in addition to the natural calamities cover, meron tayong cover for pests and diseases. Okay. So ano yung mga pests and diseases natin na yan? We insure the number one enemy of rice farmers, and that is tungro. Yeah. And that is pests also. Yes, we have rats. So lahat yun na mga kadahilanan na ang magsasaka kung hindi siya nakalamidad o hindi siya nabagyo, natuyot, o hindi siya nabaha, kakaroon din ng pest. So, those are the risks na pinoprotektahan ng crop insurance for both rice and corn undertaking. Ang amount of insurance natin for rice is and corn is computed on a per hectare basis. The coverage runs for a maximum of 120 days, and the coverage is on a cropping season basis. So generally, we have two cropping seasons, di ba? Meron tayong tinatawag na wet season and dry season. Although under climate change, we really cannot distinguish now which is a wet season and which is a dry season. Minsan, nangyari kabaliktaran. Okay. So, on a per hectare basis, we give, yung gaya ng sinabi ko, an amount of insurance from a minimum of 25,000 up to a maximum of 65,000. And in the case of corn, up to a maximum of 78,000. Mahal kasi ang corn. Yung seeds lang ng corn, yung per kaban seed, masyadong mahal na yun. That is why higher yung cost ng, at saka mahal din yung mga chemicals natin in corn production. Itong high value crop natin, ito yung insurance coverage natin for all other crop production activities other than rice. So, sabi ko kanina, nandyan yung vegetables, nandyan yung pinakbet natin, down there in the north, and then nandyan yung sangkap ng chop suey natin, and lahat ng ingredients natin. So, those are our vegetables, Nandun din ang ano natin, meron yung ornamentals natin. So those who are in commercial flower ano gardening or flower farming, may insurance coverage sila, and we have the trees. So yun, lahat yun covered natin. Today, would like to inform you na meron na tayong 83 policies for high value crops. Yung insurance cover natin for high value can either be tree mortality cover lang, that is especially for the non-fruit bearing trees, and now we are developing our yield mortality yield insurance cover for trees. Nakagaya kung ano, kasi noon under the tree mortality insurance cover natin, namin, hindi magbabayad ng PCIC kung ang tree na nakisiguro ay hindi matutumba at hindi mamamatay. Okay. Pero ang sabi ng mga producers natin o ang demand ng ating mga yung mga nagmamangga, yung those who are in commercial tree farming, sabi nila, yung mangga nila pwedeng hindi matumba. Pero ang risk nila is yung pagka umaambon-ambon lang, masisira na yung flowers, nalalaglag na, hindi na matuloy yung ano. So that is a loss on the part of the farmer. So yun na yung mga risk. We are starting now, we are developing now our yield cover. Kasi pag ganun nang nangyari, yung expected yield na ay hindi na niya makuha. And he, if he is insured, then insurance come to his assistance. So that is our high value crop. So doon sa mga trees na what we call na perennial, meron yung insurance cover, 1 year, 2 years, meron pa yung hanggang sa up to 5 years old hanggang mamunga na. Di ba? Yun yung mga long gestating natin. Pero dito sa mga vegetables natin, lalo na yung mga short gestating lang, meron yung 60 days, 72 days, ano na yun, lang, gaya ng tomatoes natin, maha-harvest na yan. So, insurance is from date of planting up to date of harvest for this to sa mga short gestating natin. That is the amount of cover for our high value crop insurance. Ang bas ano ang basehan natin upang mabigyan ng insurance yung ano crops natin. Sabi ko kanina, the basis is on a per hectare basis. Kung ano yung capital natin in producing that crop on a per hectare basis, yun yung i-insure natin. So say for example now, meron tayo even in tomato production, we can have basic expense on a per hectare basis from a low of 70,000 up to a high of 90,000. No. So that is a 1 hectare basis. Kung ang i-insure niya farm is 1 hectare lang, simply hatiin yun. If another one, kasi mayroon lang yung up to 0.25 only, another hati. So ganun ang bilangan natin kung magkano ang halaga ng insurance on a per hectare basis. Okay. So anong covered natin sa livestock insurance natin? Ito ang pinaka, dito in Metro Manila and its suburbs, and even dito sa mga malalapit na places, up to Pampanga, Pangasinan, Laguna, Batangas, ang marami na ano natin dito sa livestock insurance is they are into poultry raising or poultry production, and meron din tayo sa livestock. So yun ang pinaka main na ano natin na ini-insure natin. So nandun yung poultry natin, nandun yung mga baka natin, nandyan din yung kalabaw natin. Although again, research says that kalabaw is now a nawawala na, vanishing. Magiging extinct na ano na, na ano natin. Although the kalabaw should be preserved, there is a program to preserve our kalabaw kasi he is a farmer's friend. So, how do we insure sa poultry? So, there are 2 types of insurance cover in poultry. One may be in yung laying, egg laying layers. So we have our layer chicken and we have your broiler chicken. Yan yung binibenta na natin at age 36 up to 40, pwede nang ibenta, di ba? Then we have limits of coverage for broilers. It at least ang pwede nating i-insure no commercial scale should be 5,000 heads.